For all the latest updates, subscribe to News9.
Hello, you're watching News9 Digital. I'm Abhijit Singh Bhamra, and today I'm here to present to you a very interesting, or should I say, a lesser known story about Mahendra Singh Dhoni. Now, we all know MS Dhoni, the Captain Cool, Mr. Cool, the Rambo from Ranchi, arguably the greatest Indian captain ever, but not many people know that he has a very cordial relationship with all the on-field umpires. You can ask the likes of Simon Toffel and others, and they'll say as to how cool is MS Dhoni on the field. But if there is one umpire which MS Dhoni had a little bit of tussle with during his playing days for Team India, remember, he's not done yet, but I'm talking about an incident which goes way back to 2011, when the on-field umpire was Australian Daryl Harper. Yes, India and Australia, they never to come along very well, be it Andrew Simons and Harbhajan Singh or even Saurav Ganguly and Greg Chappell. But let's stick to MS Dhoni and Daryl Harper here. So the incident was in the first test match between India and West Indies in the Caribbean. And what happened there? Well, India won the test match by 63 runs, but apart from the result, MS Dhoni wasn't too happy with Daryl Harper and his dubious decisions which he made during the test match. And what happened out in the middle? Well, he did say to the on-field umpire, Daryl Harper, that Daryl, we have had some issues with you in the past, don't forget that. Now, the background of the story is that MS Dhoni was the captain of the team and Daryl Harper actually banned Praveen Kumar, who was playing his debut test match over there in West Indies. Now, he was warned twice on running on the pitch, and then when the third time this happened, according to the ICC rules, you got to take the bowler out of the innings. He cannot bowl anymore. So, MS Dhoni walked up to Daryl Harper and said that you got to be a little more lenient to the debutant, to which Daryl Harper said that he has played over 50 ODIs, so he must be knowing the rules. So that was the tussle going on that led to Dhoni saying to Daryl Harper that, listen, we have had some issues with you in the past, make sure that it doesn't surface again. So what is the history behind this? Why is Dhoni saying that we have had issues with you, Daryl Harper, for this? We have to go way back to 2000 again. The bowler this time was Ashish Nehra, and remember, Dhoni wasn't a part of Team India back then. He made his debut in December 2004. So then what happened there? Ashish Nehra too was first, he was given two warnings, and then later he was taken off the attacks. So Dhoni was very much aware of history of Daryl Harper with the Indian team over here. So what is it that Dhoni did? After the test match, after India won the test match, Dhoni actually went into the press conference and said that had correct decisions been made, I would have been chilling in my hotel room and not giving this press conference, to which Daryl Harper took an offense and also said that ICC should look into the matter. But because of the BCCI pressure, it was reported that no action was taken against MS Dhoni. So you can see there is a lot of history, there are lots which happens behind the scenes, and that is exactly why Dhoni got away with, if one can say that, you know, he was obviously sledging Daryl Harper there. Daryl Harper, to his credit, was standing in his last series as the ICC umpire. And so what happened? They next two test matches, he was taken out of the series, and he was no longer allowed to officiate in the matches. And what happens then if you take on MS Dhoni? Well, you got to pay the price, you got to have bear the repercussions, if I can say that way. So what do you think about the story? Do you think that Dhoni was right in his purview of actually going under the skin of an umpire? Or do you think that MS Dhoni should have just spoken to the umpire in a more polite way? Do send in your comments and feedback, and I'll be looking forward to the same. In the meantime, do not forget to subscribe to News9 Digital across all social media platforms.